This is Coach Steve, the Affordable Life Coach. I've been coaching clients for over 13 years now. If you are interested in affordable life coaching, send me an email. It's in the description. This is just a small practice, daily practice that we can do that has huge rewards and return on energy invested. And it makes such a difference on our spiritual, on our mental, and our physical health. And that's so easy. Simply get a dose of nature in the morning. It's more beneficial, you know, start your day first thing in the morning if possible, and end your day with a dose of nature. Nature has such a calming, peaceful, grounding effect on our spirit, on our brains, on our psychology, on our emotional state. And we want to bathe ourselves as much as possible in nature. There's a great book called The Nature Fix, and it talks about all the mental benefits that we get just even being 15 minutes in nature. This video is not even saying 15 minutes. Even if you can get 5 minutes of nature to start your day, get some sunlight in your face, on your eyes. So you're not looking directly in the sun, but you're exposing your eyes to sunlight. It's such a great way to set your circadian rhythm, to start your day in a more positive, upbeat mood. Because how do most people start our days? We stare at a screen, have a cup of coffee to get the energy and to shake off the sleepiness. But can you imagine if you started the habit of just getting 5 minutes of nature in the morning, your dose of 5 minutes of nature in the morning and 5 minutes in the evening? It's like taking vitamins. It is going to have a huge ripple effect that will positively impact the rest of your day. And that's something I do religiously, of getting a dose of nature in the morning and before it gets dark. And a lot of people think, oh, I'm not near nature, and it's too far to go to a hiking trail, or how can I access nature? Hey, if you have trees, if there's birds, if there's flowers, there's nature. You have access to nature. And one of the things to look for is, can you hear the birds? If you can hear the birds, that's a good spot. A quieter neighborhood, or going to a park, or just even stepping outside and walking a block down your street, getting that dose of nature, listening to birds. And if you don't have birds, just, you know, watching the trees, looking at flowers, and being present while you do that. Getting off the phones, not having your listening to podcast or music or whatever it is, just really unplugging and connecting to nature and being present makes such a difference. When I'm coaching clients, a lot of times they think that they need like a drastic change or some big fix, or they can't understand why their mood is low, or they're feeling stressed, or they're feeling anxious. And we're not designed. We're like a fish out of water. We are not designed for the environment that we put ourselves in. We are not designed to be surrounded by four walls, not exposing ourselves to sunlight, to fresh air, to trees, to birds, to greenery. That is not how human beings have been and lived their lives for, you know, thousands of years. We always, before the Industrial Revolution, we've always had a connection with nature. And a lot of the things that we struggle with can be alleviated just by getting outdoors as much as we possibly can. And if you could even get a third dose, you know, sometimes I'll find like in the middle of the day when I have a break between my sessions, or if I'm doing other work, if I could just get a 5-10 minute short dose of nature, because I feel like if I sit too long or I'm indoors too long, I start melting. I feel like my spirit, my body starts melting. Some of my clients, they'll complain of neck pain and back pain from staring at a screen or sitting too long. And just going out for 5-10 minutes, it's like topping up your phone and recharging your battery. It feels so good, and you'll be amazed at the, it's such a low effort activity, and which pays such high dividends. So yeah, the book, I recommend the Nature Fix, because in that book, I think it's the female author, she talks about like 45 minutes in studies they've done. 45 minutes, the trees release some type of chemical that when we breathe it in, it makes us feel good. But even 15 minutes, man, even 5-10 minutes is good. And so like the beginner step of this is start with small doses and then gradually working your way up. And if you'd like support in accomplishing a habit or goal like this, along with other, a wide plethora of areas of your life you want to improve upon, and you want some general accountability, life coaching makes a world of difference. And we set goals like these. But you can start small. And that's what I encourage my clients, is start small, take baby steps, and then gradually work your way up. But getting your dose of nature, if you're a beginner, 5 minutes in the morning, maybe 5 minutes in the afternoon, and 5 minutes before you go to sleep. So just mean, if it means you just step out your door, but it's got to be unplugged. You step out your door and you just look at the trees, you look at the flowers, and you just be present. And if you want to kick it up a notch, going on longer walks, you know, maybe setting a walking goal of you're going to do 5,000 steps a day or 10,000 steps or whatever your baseline is, you know, gradually increasing that. And that's something that could get you extra motivated of being able to see your step count and knowing that if you're outdoors walking, you're getting your dose of nature. Just try to avoid busy streets where there's noise pollution, because that will really wear on us, and it creates that low level of stress and anxiety. We have too much noise. The idea is to unplug from stimulation and noise, and it feels so good. But we are so overstimulated in this society and in our culture. We were not hardwired to handle this type of overload, and then people can't understand why they're stressed, why they're anxious, why they're feeling depressed, or why they're feeling down. We need sunlight, we need calm, we need silence, we need stillness, we need to move, we need to breathe deeply, we need to not just be sedentary and passive, we need to be active and engaged with the world, with our environment, and with life. Oh man, and it feels really, really good. And a lot of the things that you struggle with or thought you struggled with take care of themselves just by getting your dose of nature. When I get my dose of nature, I notice I come back, I'm feeling happier, I'm feeling more productive, or that I have the ability to be more productive. I feel more focused, I can concentrate, I feel calmer, I feel more relaxed, I feel more peaceful. The ripple effect is immense just by getting that dose of nature. Now, if you want to go to the advanced level, this, I don't have a car, so it's not as easy for me to go to hiking trails. But when I do go to hiking trails, or when I have done it in the past, or when I did that solo bicycle trip halfway across country, it is absolutely one of the most powerful experiences when you can spend extended periods of time in nature. And it could be like, you know, a half day hike, or even a 2 or 3 hour hike. It just transforms how we look at ourselves, how we look at the world. It's kind of like when you spend too much time indoors, you're looking through the world through these dark gray glasses. And especially if you're on the computer and the internet and it's all doom and gloom and negative stuff, or your social media and you're comparing yourself to other people. When you start moving and engaging with nature, exposing yourself to nature, it's like those dark gray glasses or that cloud that hangs over you clears, and you have that sunlight. Think you're just more optimistic, you're more positive, you're more motivated and driven to accomplish the things that you want out of your life. It's magical. It really is. Not to overstate it, but it is absolutely magical. And a big part of it is it allows us to connect with God. It allows us to alive, enliven our spirit. Being indoors, we're just disconnected from source. We're disconnected from God. We're disconnected from that energy force field that being in nature reverberates through our being. And it becomes non-optional. Like I've realized in my life that if I don't give myself an option not to do it, despite the weather. Hey, if you're worried about the weather, just bundle up, bring an umbrella, do whatever you got to do. And even if it's just 5 or 10 minutes, that's a victory. But I know if I don't do that, I'm going to pay a much worse price on how I feel physically, emotionally, mentally, and spiritually. And I notice that with my clients, and the clients that do take up a goal like this, getting their dose of nature. Yeah, I've never heard someone say, oh, you know, it's not worth it, or I don't notice any benefits of it. It's something that is just, it's like brushing our teeth, but it's enjoyable. And if you want to make more of a connection with nature, you know, you could start trying to identify the birds. You could take a photo of the bird, then come home and look up what type of bird it is. Or now they have, again, I don't want to get too close, use the phones, but they have even apps now. I haven't used any, but I've heard there's apps now. You just record a bird and you can identify it. And that makes it more engaging. Some people like to take photography. So, you know, whatever works for you. But just setting that goal and setting a reminder, getting out in nature, being able to see the sun set, even if it's, you know, you're not on the coast, but you could still see the sun go down. It's just wonderful. And if you can't do that, or you want to add something in addition to that, just listening to nature sounds is really, really good. Or watching a nature video on YouTube. There's some incredibly breathtaking nature scenes on YouTube of places all over the world, of waterfalls, of jungles, of natural forests. And just watching that can have a positive impact. Not the same as being there, but if you don't have access to that, you know, that's another resource that you can utilize. But I'm curious for you to write in the comments how you get your dose of nature. And even if it means just, you know, going in the backyard, that's fine. You know, just going near a tree, that's fine. But I'm curious how you, if any of you are able to incorporate this into your lifestyle and how you successfully do it. So please comment. If you want affordable life coaching and support on these and other life goals, send me an email. The consultation's free and the sessions afterwards are ridiculously affordable. And please like, comment, subscribe. And there's a PayPal link. It means a lot to me if you are interested and want to support the channel. There's a way that you can do it. Thanks for watching. Thanks for commenting. And I look forward to the next session.